Our second guest this evening is a veteran stand-up comedian and one of my favorite writers who recently wowed audiences with his one-man show, Unacceptable. He's still doing that right now and is also known for being the co-creator of this little vehicle called The Chappelle Show. Yeah. So if you didn't know, now you know. This is Neal Brennan, Neal Brennan, Neal Brennan.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, dude.
First of all, it's good to be here on OnlyFans. Everybody vaxxed? Not me. Let me tell you why. Could we lock the doors very quickly? two and a half hours. How are you, buddy?
Well, why are you not vaxxed?
No, I'm vaxxed. I'm kidding.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I'm like quadruple vaxxed. Vax every morning, first thing. Did you lose? Do you know, a buddy of mine wouldn't take the vax. And I go, why won't you take it? And he goes, I just don't want to mess with my DNA like that. It's like, you know, Gary, I've met your family. Go ahead and roll the dice on the DNA, huh, buddy?
Back.
Hey. My porn habits changed also, Arsenium.
Oh, tell us about them.
Yeah, thank you. I have bits. I'm going to do bits. My porn habits changed. When you go on Pornhub, what's your... You know what I mean?
Yeah. You know, okay, sometimes, you know, I sometimes still put on an old DVD because I miss, like, Candy Apples. She was bad, you know, but she's not on Pornhub.
She hasn't been transferred over to Pornhub?
I'm gonna check.
Digitized?
I would love to see her titties digitized, though. I'm waiting.
Normally I go on Pornhub and I'm just kind of like, surprise me.
Oh, you know? I know what I do. I go on PornTube.
Same idea. Okay, good.
I didn't mean to interrupt you with that meaningless information. But it kind of looks like YouTube.
By the way, that's the oldest you've ever sounded. It was like you woke up from a nap. Like, I go on porn too. So normally I'm like a surprise me kind of guy. Like, you tell me, Pornhub. Old Greek ladies? All right, I'll try it. And during the lockdown, I found myself watching a lot of orgies because I think I just wanted to see that many people together.
That's a great joke.
I have some questions for you.
Okay.
Because I don't. Did you say in the intro, like, I used to go to tapings of the original 30 years ago.
Yes.
Like, me and Dave were 18. Me and Dave Chappelle.
Yes.
Dave would be on the show sometimes.
But one time, you both were just standing on the side, hanging out.
Couple of 18-year-old runaways. That's how you make it sound.
Yeah.
But my question for you is, like, what was it like to be you in that? Like, what was it like? Like, what was it like for you personally being, like, cover Time Magazine? Yeah. Like, a few times. Like, it seemed like a very hot spotlight.
Yeah, it was cool because in show business, you usually get papered up and take care of your mom, buy her a house, and all that kind of shit. The cool thing about what I was doing is it allowed me to open the gate and let some other people get papered up and put people on TV. And that was great because when I was coming up, you could watch TV and you didn't see a brown person or a black person. You didn't see Celia Cruz on NBC. Or you didn't see, you know, nobody. And I felt like I have this opportunity to let the have-nots get their shit off.
Yeah.
You know, so it was fun. And I'd be at the Improv and I'd be like, George Lopez, somebody introduced me to this motherfucker right here. You know, and It was cool. I felt like a hero in that way.
For like putting people on.
Yeah, because usually show business usually is just for you. You know,
yeah.
It's just for you to get cheesed up. I had been a stand-up who goes on Joan Rivers, doing well every time I went on, and then I think she got fired. What did the agent say? Yeah, got fired, and then her husband committed suicide.
Hold on, what did they? Yep, she got fired.
Yeah, you got fired. And so I had been a guy that was in their face all the time, and it was like, give it to him or the stage manager.
Right.
You know? And so I got the Joan Rivers show, and then it went from there. And of course, then, you know. Yeah.
And was it, how hard was it to book those, like, Eddie, Michael Jackson shows?
They kind of booked themselves because Eddie loved Michael, and Michael loved Eddie, and MTV wanted to give them both an award, and they didn't come to the MTV Awards, which I used to host every year. So I said, hey, send me the awards. I'll get them here, and we'll have them give each other the award. And so that worked out.
Okay. How
And about? Michael arrived long before we had these. Michael arrived. I had never seen a KN95 before. And Michael arrived with his own mask on and some orange juice. And this, I was like, okay, I get that, but I got juice, nigga. But I think we have to go. I know it's YouTube, but
we're losing our OnlyFans? Is that what you're saying?
I think, but I want to come see your new hour.
I'm doing Unacceptable here in LA. I think it's sold out. I'll put you on the...
You know what? They just added a show. Don't give me that bullshit. They just added a... I saw that. There were two shows. They added a third one.
That sold out, buddy. I'm going to get...
That one sold out, too? I just looked last night.
No, I know. You know what? I think they released 10 tickets. I got you.
Okay.
I got you. And I'm touring it. Go to neilbrennan.com/shows.
Yes. Give it up for the great Neal Brennan.
Thank you.
The Neal Brennan Show. Give him 4 nights.